Welcome back to the Windows Registry Hacks video series. In this episode, I will show you three useful registry tweaks to customize the context menu in Windows. The registry tweak can save you time by allowing you to quickly move files and folders to any location on your computer. We will be adding copy to and move to option to the context menu in today's episode, as well as I will disable the send to menu also. So these hacks can save you time by streamlining your file management workflow. So let's get started. So my first hack would be adding copy to the context menu. So first I'm going to show you how the context menu look like. If you right click any files, you did not get any move to or copy to option over here. Okay. So now I'm going to create it. So for that, first you have to open the registry editor. To open the registry editor, first you have to press Windows plus R on keyboard. And here in the run command box, you have to type regedit and click on OK. This will open the registry editor page. So in the left hand side under computer, you will find HKEY classes root. So click here to expand this. So after that, you have to scroll little bit and you will find all file system objects. So you have to identify this all file system objects. So click here to expand this also. So under this you will find shell X. You need to click here, and under this you will find context menu headers. So what you have to do, you have to just right click over here and select new and the select key. So now you have to name this key. I'm going to name it copy to. You have to name this exactly what I'm going to write it over here. So okay, so in the right hand side under name you will find default. You have to double click on it and you have to give some value data over here. So this is a long string, so I'm going to copy it from my notepad. Okay, and accordingly I'm going to paste it over here. So don't worry, I will give you all the strings in my description below in the video. So that you can directly copy it from here, you can paste it over here. Okay, so now I'm going to click on OK. Your work is done. Now you have to just minimize this. Now I'm going to check it once again. I'm going to just right click on the file. And now here you will find copy to folder option is showing over here. Okay, so previously it was not there. Now you will find copy to folder option is there. Okay, so this is how you can add copy to function in the right click context menu. Okay, so my second hack could be adding move to the context menu. So this is the same way how we can add copy to in the context menu. Exactly the same way I am going to add the move to in the context menu. So for that, once again you have to press Ctrl plus R on keyboard and you have to write regedit and click on OK. So in the registry editor page, in the same way, under HKEY classes root, you will find here you will find all file system objects. You have to scroll little bit and then you will find all file system objects. You have to open this, and under this you have to also open shell X, and in the context menu headers you have to just right click on it and select new and key. So in the same way, you have to name it move to. Okay, in the right hand side, you have to select the value data over here. In the same way, I'm going to copy it from my notepad and you will get it from my description. Okay, so we'll directly copy from here and paste it and click on OK. So my work is done. Now, once again, we are going to check it. So for that, you have to just minimize this. Now I'm going to check it whether it will add in my context menu or not. So for that, once again right click on the file and here you will find my move to folder also added in my context menu along with copy to folder. So see, there is a copy to folder and move to folder. So this is the way you can add copy to and move to folder in the right click context menu. Hope it will helpful. So my third hacks would be disable the send to menu. So where you will find send to menu? In the file location If I am going to right click over here, you will find send to. Okay, actually the send to menu can be useful for quickly sending files to a specific location, but it can also be cluttered with unnecessary options. Okay, so by disabling it, you can simplify your context menu and make it more efficient. So the same way, you have to just open the registry database. So I minimize over here, so I need to maximize it, and here you will find in the same way, under all file system objects you will find shellx. Under shellx you will find context menu headers. So you are going to click here to expand this, and here you will find send to. You need to just click it over here, and in the right hand side you have to just double click on default. Now you have to just disable this value data. So it will be best if you just cut it from here and copy anywhere in your place, so that in future if you need this, you can copy it from here. Okay, and then click on OK. That means you have deleted all your value data. In the same way, if you want, you can also right click over here and delete this send to options. And are you sure you want to permanently delete this key and all your sub keys? Just you have to click on yes. You can either delete the value data, or you can directly completely delete the send to functions. Now if you are going to minimize this, and once again the same way, if I am going to right click on the file system, now you will find the send to option is disappear from here. If you click any of the files also, you did not get any send to options over here. Okay, so one thing you must be notice, this the change should take effects immediately after making them in a registry editor. So no need to restart your PC. So this is how you can adding copy to and move to in the context menu, as well as you can, if you want, you can disable the send to function also. So that's it for this episode for customizing the context menu in Windows using registry tweaks. Remember to always backup your registry before making any changes. In the next episode, I will be sharing more registry tweaks that you can use to enhance your Windows experience. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel to get notified when the next episode is released. So thank you for watching. I will see you in my next video.